While it may not have been the best week of sales ever, I did have a couple higher priced items go out the door. One of those being one of those vintage Tommy Hilfiger jackets that I showed you a couple weeks ago. So if you want to hear about what sold this week on Poshmark and eBay, stay tuned.
Won't nobody love you the way they should. Won't nobody check up on you, make sure you're good. Won't nobody check those body cameras by your neck.
Hey everyone, my name is Becky Park and this is my YouTube channel. And on this YouTube channel, I talk about what kinds of items are selling for me as a part-time reseller on eBay and Poshmark. And I also have videos on different tips and tricks that I have learned along the way when it comes to reselling. When I'm not reselling part-time, I am a full-time choir teacher. And this is really like probably one of the busiest seasons for me because my a cappella groups are asked to sing at all kinds of events. So even today during our lunch period, we're gonna go over to our district central office and sing for them. This past week, we've been singing at nursing homes and we've been singing for different office parties and things of that nature. So while it's been really busy, it has been making us a lot of money and it's been really fun. It's a really good group of kids and you know, who doesn't love singing Christmas carols? As you can tell, I am in kind of a different setting today. We are sitting in front of my Christmas tree. It is not like a professional tree by any means, but it contains a lot of memories and family traditions and ornaments, especially that are really special to my family, things that my kids have made, and it's the season, right? So why not? So in this video, I'm gonna be sharing with you what kinds of items have sold for me in the last week. If you enjoy these kinds of videos, consider subscribing as I do make one of these every week. And at the end of the video, if you enjoyed it, make sure that you hit that like button because it does help out my channel quite a bit. So let's get right in. Like I said at the very beginning, this wasn't like the most ludicrous week of sales whatsoever, but I did have a couple high ticket items that sold, so I'm really excited about those. But let's go ahead and start with Monday, which was December 2nd. By the way, this is probably the latest that I'm ever filming a What Sold video, and that's because earlier this week I did put out a couple videos. One was eBay tips from a Poshmark seller, just because eBay was something that I started way late in the game as far as reselling goes. I think I was selling on Poshmark predominantly for like a year and a half or something before I decided to also sell on eBay. And like this past week that I'm gonna talk about here, it wasn't like the most amazing when it comes to eBay, but this week that we're in right now, today's Friday, but this week has been a really good eBay week. So if you have been reselling and you kind of feel like maybe you're plateauing on just Poshmark or just Mercari or just Etsy, I do highly recommend also giving eBay a try. And that's why I made that video on just kind of my perspectives of how to sell on eBay successfully, coming from someone who started on a different platform. I also have a video that I did in collaboration with Amber from Amber Resells, and we are in the midst of trying to list 100 items from our death piles within a 2-week span. So if you're interested in seeing how my first week went, you can check out this video right here as well. Wow, how come I forgot how to do this? I think it's here. But you can check out that video. And we are in the midst of week 2 of that challenge. And so far, I am on track to get to 100 listings. All of that being said, yes, I am filming this super late. That is why. But let's talk about what sold. So Monday, December 2nd, I did have a really good day on Poshmark with 0 eBay sales. And the first thing that sold was the St. Louis Cardinals Majestic Attire Jersey shirt. It was a boys' youth. There goes my papers. It was a boys youth size 10 shirt. I got this last year. I got it from the boutique section of Goodwill. And I got it because I think it was like around the holidays time even last year. And I thought that it would make a great gift for someone who is a hardcore St. Louis Cardinals fan. It did not sell last year, but it sold this year. And it sold for $15. And so I took home $12 on that sale. The next item that sold was this pair of Rock Revival Sherry Mid-Rise Bootcut Jeans in a size 24. I got these for free from a friend of mine from church who gave me like 7 garbage bags filled to the brim with all the stuff that she just wasn't wearing anymore. This was my first time selling Rock Revival jeans and I didn't really know what to expect. I had them priced pretty high, probably around like $68 or something like that. I think someone sent me an offer for $40, which I accepted because I was kind of running this sale in my Poshmark closet, like a buy one, get one free. She wasn't, you know, trying to get something else with it, but $40, I was like, that's fine. So I took home $32 on that item. She did only leave me like a 2 or 3 star review, and she said it was because the jeans fit kind of baggy for a size 24. They weren't mine. I didn't have a way to know if they were baggy. I'm also not super familiar with this brand of jeans. So at the end of the day, all you can do is, you know, show your measurements or list your measurements and hope that the buyer will also look to see what you put as the measurements. But at the end of the day, you just can't make every single buyer happy. I still got paid and it is what it is. I don't know, like it stinks for the buyer, obviously. I am grateful that she didn't try to open a case because Poshmark, you know, does not allow for buyers to return items based on fit, especially if the seller does their due diligence and puts their measurements. And I think that's why she knew, you know, it wasn't worth it to open a case. I am sorry that she wasn't pleased with the purchase, but at the end of the day, like there's only so much I can do apart from listing the measurements or showing the measurements in my pictures. The next thing that sold was a big bundle and it went to a viewer named Valeria. I hope I'm saying your name right. But Valeria, thank you so much for this bundle. It was an 8-piece bundle and Monday the 2nd was the last day of my like Black Friday, Thanksgiving, Cyber Monday sale. I was running a buy one, get one free sale in my Poshmark closet and she took advantage of not only that, but my four for $25 sale. It's this everlasting sale that I have in my Poshmark closet. So she had four items from my four for $25 and four items that she utilized the buy one, get one free sale for. So the items that she picked up were this pair of Fila bike shorts and they were like black and I wanna say coral colored, color blocked biking shorts, like kind of mid thigh length in a size medium. That reminds me, I need to start going to the YMCA and like using the membership that I paid for. Anyway, the next item was this Newith Tags Umji, which is just like a boutique brand that sold at various boutiques around the nation. Ombre striped tunic with like this really pretty beige and again, I think kind of coral or like orange color in a size small. It was kind of strappy up here and just a really unique shirt. I'd never seen anything like it before. And the next item was this four for $25 H&M basic cream oversized sweater in a size medium. That was given to me for free by a friend. The next item was something that I picked up in one of my earliest thrift hauls. I still remember finding it at a Salvation Army and being like, I scored a jackpot. Like, this is the big time, people. It is this Columbia pink fleece pullover in a size small. And it was like two-tone pink, but it was just really lightweight, really thin fleece pullover, not something that resells for a ton of money. But when I was first starting out, I was like, Columbia at the thrift store? Whoa. And I had that in my four for $25 sale. The next item was this J. Crew wool velvet tie pleated A-line skirt in a size 6. This was also from one of my earliest thrift hauls, but I feel like it's actually a really good piece and super substantial. If I remember correctly, it had like a really subtle houndstooth print on it. And it's just a really darling skirt, velvet trim, velvet tie. I think the issue with this skirt is just that it's kind of at like an awkward length. I think it hits kind of like mid-thigh, like definitely above the knee. It's not really something that you would wear to work because of the length. It's a little short for most office settings, but like the materials used are appropriate for the office. So I think it just took a special buyer who could style it really well. I could see this looking so cute with a pair of tights and like Oxford pumps or just, and like an oversized sweater. It could be really cute. Just again, not really something that you would wear in a typical office setting, but just super darling. The next item was this Nike Relay long sleeve running shirt in a size small. It was like this really nice blue color. I think it had the thumb holes, perfect for going out for a run. And then she also picked up this 4 for $25 Talbots gingham lime print skirt in a size 10. Like literally one of the cutest skirts I've ever seen in my entire life. Gingham print and it had embroidered limes all over it. I got it at an estate sale that I went to definitely last year. I don't go to very many estate sales, but I remember going to this one and it was really fun. They had some really cool stuff. A lot of older, more mature brands like Talbots. I feel like I remember picking up Soft Surroundings and like Banana Republic, but this person also had this really cool vintage Columbia fanny pack that I remember I sold for a decent amount. And just some other items that, you know, I did really well on. I think I also got this other, no, I don't think I got this other item from that estate sale, but it had a similar feel to it. It was this Talbots embroidered blue eyelet pencil skirt in a size 6 petite. Again, just like a really classic, beautiful skirt. It wasn't just like plain black, but it had some design to it and it was just really cute. So all of those items, again, there were four items that were in my four for $25 sale. So she got those four items for $25. And then the other four items were part of my buy one, get one free sale. So when all was said and done, the bundle came out to $75. I made $60 on them. I was able to move out a lot of older inventory, which I was really thankful and excited for, and she got some great pieces. So again, Valeria, thank you so much. I hope you loved everything. And in fact, she already sent me a love note saying that she did love everything. So I am so thankful that you enjoyed your purchase, and I hope you come visit my Poshmark closet again soon. Tuesday the 3rd, I sold zero things on all of the platforms. So that's always exciting. On the 4th, which was Wednesday, I sold one item on Poshmark, but I was okay with it because it was an exciting sale. It was my vintage Tommy Hilfiger denim trucker button-up jacket with like the big Tommy Hilfiger flag on the back. It was embroidered on. This was from the 90s and it was a size medium and it was in mint condition. I will link the video here where I show you the video. I just happened to walk into Goodwill one day. I was super sick. It was like the week of this crazy sinus infection that I had gotten, but I was going to Dollar Tree or I don't know. I was just like in the plaza of this Goodwill that's really nearby. And so I just popped in. I just went to the boutique section for like 15 minutes and a Goodwill worker was putting out this vintage Tommy Hilfiger like windbreaker. And it's one of those windbreakers that can turn into a fanny sack. Why do I keep saying fanny sack? Fanny pack. It converts into a fanny pack. It like folds into itself and within like the big tummy pocket, it's not a tummy pocket, but there's like a pocket right below the chest or right below like whatever, right here. And you can like put, you stuff the jacket into itself and inside of the pocket, there were like these straps that you can buckle around your waist to turn it into a fanny pack. I mean, it was just so cool. And she was putting it out and like literally as she placed it on the rack, I took it off and I put it in my cart. I don't even think I had a cart, but I just put it in my arms. And then I just looked more in that jacket area and I found this denim jacket and my mind literally was just like, whoosh. And I was like, there's no way that these are actual vintage, but after careful investigation and asking people on my Instagram and YouTube, people were like, that is for sure 90s. I was so excited. I still have the windbreaker in my Poshmark closet if you're interested. And this denim jacket sold to someone on Poshmark for $100. I was so excited. So I made $80 off of that. I only had them listed for, you know, less than a month, maybe like a couple weeks, a few weeks. So super excited about that. First time finding Tommy vintage goodness such as that. And I'm happy to have moved it for $100. Next up, I had an eBay auction end. This person actually still hasn't sold yet. I just went ahead and put it in here. I have a feeling it's not gonna sell, but it's not like I would have made a lot of money off of it anyway. It is from my student's garage sale. The brand is Kamik, K-A-M-I-K. I've never heard of it before, but it was this pair of hiking sandals with like the adjustable bungee. They looked like Keens, but they were not Keens. And the style name on the sandal was called the Cape May. They were in a size 8, men's. I had the auction starting at $6.99. I got one bid on it and I had them paying for $7.85 of shipping because at the time that's how much it cost me to do a padded flat rate envelope. So if the buyer pays after shipping and all of that, I will make $5.58, half of which will go to the theater company at my school, half of which I will put in my pocket. So all $2.54. However, like I said, I haven't gotten paid yet. So I have sent out like a payment reminder. I'm gonna go ahead and open an unpaid case today on eBay. I mean, it's not like a huge deal. It wasn't a large sum of money, but I will go ahead and relist the item if I don't get paid, you know, in a couple days here. On Thursday the 5th, I did have one sale on Poshmark. It was a nice little small sale, but I appreciate it nonetheless. It was a skirt that I got for free from a friend and it was in my four for $25 sale. It was this floral white pleated skirt and I said that it was T-length. T-length is basically like a midi skirt. It kind of hits like between the knees and the ankle, but it's just like very modest, very proper, if you will, and it was in a size medium. I sent out offers to likers on the skirt for $12. So after discounted shipping, I made $7.25.
This actually sold to a viewer named Amaya, and I forgot to thank her in the actual filming of the video, but I wanted to make sure I took this moment to say thank you. So Amaya, thank you for your business.
This was one of those skirts, like there was just no brand to it. Either my friend got it in Korea, where oftentimes like they don't really put brand names on all their clothing, or maybe it was one of those like more boutique items that, you know, it was just coming from a random boutique store and it didn't have a brand associated to it. I don't know. It was pretty darling, but it is a little bit harder, I think, to move items if they don't have a brand associated to them. So I was happy to make $7.25 of pure profit because, like I said, I got that for free from a friend. On Friday the 6th, zero sales. And usually Fridays are pretty good sales days. Today is Friday and I woke up to like a decent number of sales over on eBay. So I'm glad that today is not a $0 Friday, but last week, the 6th, it was. And then on Saturday, the 7th, I had another really nice price sale over on Poshmark. And it was this Free People Movement win-win quarter zip hoodie in a size small. So I went to this local thrift store in my area that actually is struggling. They've been in the papers and in the news saying that they might shut down soon just because they're not generating enough income. So I try to go there as much as I can. And I really love this thrift store and just kind of like the mission behind the organization, because they're not just about giving handouts to people in need, but they will kind of, you know, similar to Goodwill, but they will provide jobs for them and provide training for them so that they are not just receiving, but they're being equipped with how to make it in the real world. And there's a space for them to learn the skills that they need to just kind of function and flourish when it comes to, yeah, making it. So I really support their mission, and they also get some really good stuff in their thrift store. And not only is it a thrift store, but they also have like a grocery store attached to it. It's just a really interesting concept and I really like it. So I popped in there because I was trying to do some shopping for my Common Tags collaboration with Courtney. She's doing this holiday box swap, which if you are not watching, I will link her channel down below. You probably are watching, but she's doing this really cool thing where each day of December, she is doing a box swap with someone in the reseller community. My box swap video with her, I think, goes live on the 26th, so the day after Christmas. So I was trying to find stuff for this box swap, and I just saw this hanging on a rack, and I never find Free People. Like, it's very rare that I find Free People. I certainly have never found Free People Movement. That's kind of their athletic line. So I saw it and I was like, oh, this is really interesting. It was just this really cool, like kind of burnt yellow color, and it had like kind of lattice design on it. They called it lace. It's not lace, but like a lattice, you know, paneling across the middle, super oversized. It had like an adjustable, what is it called? You pull it like a bungee, but it's not bungee. It's elastic. Like you can cinch it at the waist, and it had a hood, and it was just really cool looking. When I looked it up online, it's still being sold on their website. So I don't know how it like made it to someone's house. They had worn it a few times. It wasn't new with tags or anything. And it had made its way to this thrift store already. So I brought it home. I priced it decently high, like maybe at 80 something, but pretty quickly, like within 24 hours of listing it, someone liked it. I sent out offers to likers on it for $70 with discounted shipping. And so I made $54.20 on this item. And it went to a viewer whose name is Kimmy or Kimi. I'm not sure if I'm saying it right. I have a feeling it's Kimi. But like looking at her Poshmark profile, she's just so cute, and you can tell like she just rocks this kind of stuff and can totally pull it off. So I was so happy that it went to a viewer, and she already left me a love note and said that she loved it and would be shopping for my Poshmark closet again soon. But Kimi, thank you so much for visiting my Poshmark closet. Please put a picture of yourself wearing it and rocking it on Instagram, because I know you totally can. The next item that sold this Saturday also sold to a viewer and a repeat buyer. Shelby, thank you so friggin' much. And I think Shelby is also a fellow teacher. So thank you so much for teaching and doing the work, because you and I know that it is hard. But she got this Talbots houndstooth popover, black and white houndstooth popover in a size medium. She sent me an offer on it for $12 and I accepted, so I made $9.05. This popover I thought was just super cute, super classic, super just like timeless. I got it a while ago, and I think I got it at a Salvation Army, and I had it listed in my Poshmark closet for months and months and months with very little interest. So I actually sent it in to ThredUp because I sent in a couple like ThredUp Luxe packages or rescue, whatever you want to call it. I sent in a couple, and in one of them, I also threw in this Talbot's houndstooth popover, and they accepted it, but no one bought it. So I actually reclaimed it when, you know, the time was coming up for my items to kind of expire as far as them trying to sell it on their website. So I reclaimed it and I got it back, and I finally got around to relisting it. I think maybe as part of my 100 item death pile challenge with Amber from Amber Resells. And within like a couple days of having it listed, Shelby came along and bought it. So I'm so happy that it's going to a great home because it is such a great piece. Like, it's so cool. So Shelby, I hope you enjoy that and wear it all the time. And then over on eBay, I did have a couple sales. One was this pair of Skechers men's lace-up hiking boots in a size 12. I wanna say I got these at a garage sale. I'm not 100% sure. I don't really pick up a lot of Skechers, but just because they were hiking boots, I thought I'd go ahead and give them a try. I have had them listed for quite some time, and someone finally sent me an offer of $25 on them on eBay, which I accepted. I have them paying for $10 of shipping because these are really expensive. And somehow, like, I don't know how this worked out, but I only had to pay for $8.55 of shipping. So I ended up making $21.90 on that sale. And then the next item to sell was also a men's piece. I don't remember where I got it. I want to say at the Bins or at a Goodwill nearby. But it was this Nike Golf Therma Fit Fleece V-neck sweater in a size large. It was just really interesting because it was fleece, but then it also had, like, these polyester panels along the shoulders. I don't remember how much I had them listed for, but I sent out offers to watchers on this for $17.99. I had them pay for $5 of shipping. It only ended up costing $3.82 to ship out, so I made $16.18 on that. So those were my Saturday sales. And then finally on Sunday, I had another men's piece, another kind of fleece pullover, and it was this The North Face blue and black color blocked quarter zip fleece pullover in a size extra large. I did accept a lower offer on this than I wanted to, but I mean, at the end of the day, I was fine with moving it for what I did. I accepted an offer of $16 on this. And in fact, I think that he sent me a much lower offer. And I think that this was the result of us kind of going back and forth a little bit. I wanted to get an offer of at least $15 on this, just because otherwise, you know, Poshmark will take $2.95 as their fee. And if you can get above $15 or get at least $15, it's that 20% cut. So I did get him to $16. So I made $12.80 off of this. Again, I'm not like 100% sure where I got this. I want to say just at a Goodwill or a local thrift store near me. But, you know, at the end of the day, I made $12.80. So I was fine with that. And then over on eBay, I did sell this Champion brand Stanford spell out t-shirt in a size medium, and it was gray and just said Stanford across the top. I did get this for free from a friend, I'm pretty sure, and someone sent me an offer for $10 on it, which I accepted. I had them pay for $4 of shipping, but it actually cost $3.20 to ship out, so I made $8.98. And then someone bought this through the global shipping program, which means like they're buying it, you know, internationally, they're not in the United States. And it was this The Walking Dead Trivial Pursuit new in the box game. So it did sell for $11.99 with them paying for $8.30 of shipping. I thought that it would cost more. And I think I just did like sell similar when I made the original listing. It actually only ended up costing $3.85 because it was really lightweight. So I ended up making $13.60 off of that because it did sell via promoted listings as well. So that was an additional percentage that I had to give to eBay in fees. And then finally, I was so happy that this sold just because it was like an old item of ours. It was the Sony PlayStation 2. It was the fat console, and it did come with two controllers, all of the cords, and an 8 MB. What does MB even mean? Megabyte? As you can tell, I'm like not good with tech terminology, but it was something that was in my house. Either it was my husband's old PlayStation 2 or one of my brother's old PlayStation 2s. I don't even know. but it did sell for $36. Someone sent me an offer, which I accepted because that thing has been sitting around collecting dust for God knows how long. So I had them pay for $14 of shipping. It actually ended up costing $16.34. So I made $27.16 off of something that has just been sitting around in my home for a very long time. So I was really happy with that. So when all was said and done, I sold a total of 15 things in my Poshmark closet for $267.30. And then on eBay, I only sold 6 items for a total of $93.40. It wasn't a great eBay week, like I said, but I don't know what's happening this week in eBay. My eBay store has been on fire. Like, I'm so excited. I've been getting a lot of offers every day. And I think part of it has to do with the fact that I'm running a 40% off sale, like I said, on a lot of different items. And hopefully that's just bringing a lot of traffic to my eBay store. I've also been listing really consistently, and a lot of that is because of the challenge that I've been doing with Amber over on Amber Resells. I've been listing a lot over on Poshmark, and that means I'm also cross-listing a lot over on eBay using List Perfectly. And so I think that's what's been generating a lot of sales on eBay, and I'm really excited about it. That's made me really happy. So in total, I made $360.70 on eBay and Poshmark. I had 0 Mercari sales. And that $360.70, that is the number that I made after all of the Poshmark and eBay fees, after all of the shipping. That's what's going in my bank account. That does not account for cost of goods, but my cost of goods is generally really low because I'm either getting stuff for free, or I am selling stuff from out of my house, or I am, you know, buying stuff at pretty low cost at the bins or at local Goodwill, Salvation Armies, local thrift stores, things like that. I sold a total of 12 women's pieces. Sorry, I'm like a little congested. 6 men's pieces, 1 children's piece, and 2 hard goods. It was the PlayStation 2, and it was that Walking Dead Trivial Pursuit game. So all in all, a pretty decent week. I'm really happy with the sales that I had, and I'm even more excited about this present week that we're in. So definitely make sure to hit that notification bell so that you know when I upload that video, because that I think is going to be like over $500 in sales, which for a part-time seller, I'm really pleased with. So that is my video for the week. If you guys enjoyed it, make sure to hit that like button. I hope you guys had a lot of wonderful sales, but even more importantly, I hope that you are finding time to spend time with your family and friends, because that's what the holiday season is all about. I know a lot of resellers are like, it's quarter four and I need to be selling all of the things, and I need to invest all this time in my reselling business. And yes, that's true, but also this is the time to make sure that the people around you, your loved ones, know that you care about them. And it's the time to make memories and just be still for a moment or two. So make sure that you are also doing that, investing time in your relationships with people around you. And yeah, that's all I have for you. Thank you so much, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.